In this video, we'll use window calculations in a dashboard. They allow you to perform different analytical tasks, like computing totals, percentages, differences, and so on. I'll start by adding a grid. Then I'll create some columns by adding category and extended price. I'll add another extended price column, and we'll use this to show percentage. Click the dropdown and select calculation, percent of total. And you'll see now that the grid shows a percentage value. Right-click its column header and select Add Total, Sum, to display a total value for this column. And you'll see the sum equals 100%. Now let's look at rank calculations. I'll add another extended price column to the grid and select Calculation, Rank. Each category is given a ranked number based on its extended price value. And of course, you can sort them in ascending or descending order. All right, let's get rid of the grid and add a chart item. Add extended price to the value section and order date to the arguments. Set it to quarter year. Then add another extended price to the value section and change its series type to point, line, arced. Now open its dropdown and go to calculation. You'll see that the running summary along series item is disabled because the chart doesn't have a series. I'll choose running summary along arguments, and you'll see the diagram displays the growing summary line. Let's remove the running summary from values and look at running totals along series now. Right-click on the chart and select Transpose. You'll see the order date is now a series. Now I'll add the country field to the argument section. In the extended prices dropdown, I'll choose Calculation, Running Summary Along Series. And you'll see the chart adjusts its values to show cumulative totals. Now let's look at some more advanced settings to apply calculations. Let's add a pivot grid. Then drop the extended price to values, country to columns, and two order dates to the rows section. One will reflect year intervals, and the other we'll set to quarterly. Let's look at the difference between the values from their previous quarter. Now let's switch to the data tab, and under initial state, choose expand row groups. Then remove the row totals by unchecking it here in the dropdown. I'll add another extended price value and then choose a custom calculation for it. In the pop-up, I'll choose difference for the calculation type. Select rows to perform a calculation vertically through pivot rows. The difference from option allows you to specify a value to subtract. Keep the difference as previous and click apply. Now you can see the difference between each year end and beginning as well. Negative values will have brackets around them. Then select rows within groups in the Calculate Along dropdown. Keep the difference as previous and click Apply. You'll see that the second columns now reflect the difference from the previous quarter's value. Now I'll go back and check the percentage difference and click Apply to show the difference in percent. You can also edit the expression by clicking the button here. The expression editor allows you to adjust the calculations you want to use. I'll change the offset number in the lookup from -1 to -4. With this expression, we're now calculating the difference between quarters for each previous year. So when I click apply, you'll see that the value of 35.1K is the difference between the third quarter from 2014 to 2015. Finally, let's look at moving calculations. They use neighboring values to calculate a total. I'll remove these items from the dashboard and add a new chart. Drag extended price to values and order date to arguments. Let's change the series type to spline and the arguments group interval to exact date. You'll see the chart becomes very crammed with fluctuation lines. I'm going to add another extended price value and change it to spline as well. I'll also choose a custom calculation. This time, I'll select moving calculation. I'll leave the moving along option set to arguments and change the summary function to average. Then I'll change the start offset and end offset values to 15. This means that when I click Apply, the chart will reflect averages at each point from the previous and next 15 values. And that's it for this video. To learn more about our dashboards, make sure to check out the documentation on our website. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.